Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope that you're having a great weekend. It's been a while since I filmed, so it was kind of weird getting back in front of the camera, but once I did and kind of got used to it, it felt really great. I have had a cold, so that's kind of why I've been away for a while, but I am starting to feel 100% better, and I wanted to do something today that was very spring and summer based because I'm so ready for spring and summer to come. I did a very orange and like bronzy tone colors on the face, so I hope that you are digging it. If you are new to my channel, hello, how are you? Thank you for joining me. And if you are already subscribed, I appreciate you joining me again in this Get Ready With Me. I really did have fun and just kind of tried some new colors, pulled out some older palettes in honor of the new peanut butter and jelly honey palette coming out. I think it is like the peanut butter honey palette. I wanted to do something with the peanut butter and jelly palette. Now, I remember I was having a rough time with this palette. My eyes would water a whole lot, but I tried it again, you know, and I'm thinking it was just allergies before because so far so good, knock on wood. But anyway, as you can tell by the title, this is a full Get Ready With Me from foundation routine all the way through to the lips and the setting spray. So if you want to see how I achieved this bronze, orange, summer, spring, whatever it may be look, then go ahead and just keep watching. Ugh. Hey guys, so this is like just gonna be pop into my video after my intro. But I've been MIA for a while because I lost someone really, really near and dear to my heart this week. A man that I once loved when he was a boy many years ago, and just wanted to tell you guys to never take any moments for granted and love like you've never loved anybody before every time you're with somebody that you love. Because moments and lives can be taken in an instant and you'll never get them back. So make sure you guys love with your whole heart. Not just a little bit, but every moment of every day. Let's get into the video.
I'm looking kind of red. As I'm getting older, I think I'm like maturing in features. Alright, let's get into this dang video because I got a lot to use. Just chilling and I wanted to throw some makeup on. So that's what we're gonna do. I wonder if I should do a voiceover.
Alright guys, so here I am just letting you know that my face feels nice and fresh from priming it with my toner and my moisturizer. I am getting ready to go in with my two favorite primers at the moment. This is the Pure No Filter Primer. This used to be only available for photographers. Now it is available for everyone. And my staple, the Porefessional. This is a great primer at filling in pores. Here I'm just placing the Pure Primer, the No Filter Primer, on my fingertips. I'm going to rub it together and give it some warmth so that it illuminates on my skin. I find that this does a really great job at doing exactly what it says, blurring out some of the imperfections, the redness, so that when I go in and lay the other primer, my Porefessional, its best friend at the moment, it does a good job at just making sure that I have a nice even canvas for the rest of my application. So I'm just placing that Porefessional in my T-zone area, my cheeks. I use a little bit less of this than I do the pure primer, the no filter primer, just because I want to make sure that I get this really in those pores right around the areas where they are the worst. Now I'm going in with my Sedona Lace Foundation Brush and my staple as well, the Bye Bye Redness. This is great at making sure that my skin isn't making sure that it's an even canvas and making sure that I have no redness before I lay down my foundation. So you can see here how I'm going in with this Sedona Lace foundation brush, making sure that I'm blending out that bye-bye redness as best as possible. It is a little bit of a thicker consistency, so I find that sometimes my fingers don't work as this foundation brush. Now I am going in with my two favorite foundations at the moment. I do like the mixture of these two, so I tend to use them both. I'm using the Makeup Forever HD Foundation Stick. I think this is the Ultra HD Foundation Stick. And then I'm using the Fiona Stiles Matte Foundation. I have a tendency to want a fuller coverage foundation, and I just find that these two together are amazing. They really do a good job at making sure that everything on my skin looks flawless, or everywhere on my skin looks flawless. You can see I'm having a little bit of trouble getting out the Fiona Stiles foundation because I am out and have ordered a new one since then, but I just improvised and took out the pumper and placed the rest of the foundation on my Pure Cosmetics foundation brush. In the Makeup Forever foundation, I am the color 125Y315, and in the Fiona Stiles foundation, I am the color 3, which is Warm Sand. Just in case you are a color similar to me, you wanted to go ahead and use those same products. This brush does a really great job at blending out the foundation. You can kind of see how I'm working it in using circular motions in some spots and then just kind of blending it in the best I can in other spots. I have found that some people do say, in some reviews that I have done myself, that this foundation does tend to get a little bit streaky with brushes. So if I find that it does that with this Pure brush, I just go in with my Beauty Blender and kind of pat it down. But I very rarely find that or see that, just because I do always clean this brush just to make sure that it doesn't leave that foundation streaky. Now I'm going in with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. This is the color 15 in Fair. I like this concealer in my T-zone, right where my birthmark is, my nose, and then underneath my nose area, and then my chin, just because it blends out really nicely. And then I go in with the color Fair Beige in the Tarte Shape Tape, and I go on my T-zone on top of that Maybelline Fit Me. They just blend really nicely together and give it a great coverage. And then under my eyes, I use the color Fair. I go in with dots first, and then I go into that triangle formation, just because I find if I don't do that and just go straight in with like a bunch of concealer under my eyes, it looks really cakey, and I don't like the way that it fits on top of my foundation and when I place my powder there. It just works better for me if I go in with the dots first and then go into that triangular formation. You can see that I am blending out with a Sedona Lace 224. This is a concealer brush. I use this specifically for my under eyes, just because I can get into the inner corner and the outer corner and blend it out really nicely. And then I go back in with my Pure Cosmetics, the foundation brush I was just using to blend out the concealer on the other parts of my face. Kind of blend everything together, make sure everything looks brightened and nice, and make sure that it all blends seamlessly. Just because in the same way you do your eyes, you want to not have any harsh lines on your face as well. When you're going in with foundation and concealer, you want to make sure that everything blends really nicely and that you don't have any lines that look really cakey or kind of off. Next, I'm going in with my NYX Mineral Foundation. I use this as a contour stick. It's one of the best ever sticks I have found for contour. I use the color 09, which is caramel, and I find that it's perfect for my skin tone because it doesn't sit as like a chocolate brown, but more of like that caramel tan brown, which I really, really like on my skin tone. I also find that this is a great foundation stick that really blends out nicely. It has a tendency, if you're not careful, to kind of dry pretty fast, but if you go in there, you work quickly, then it blends out really, really nicely. This is the best contour stick I've found, and I have tried the Sonia Kashuk, I've tried the L'Oreal, I've tried the Maybelline, and this one really does work well. First, I'm going to blend out with the foundation brush by Pure, that's become kind of my staple, and then I'm going back in with that concealer brush, that Sedona Lace 224, blending out my nose a little bit just to make sure that that line is not as harsh as it would be if I just went in with that foundation brush or with the Beauty Blender. So we go in, blend out that first, And then I'm going to go in with my Beauty Blender and I'm going to blend out the contour on my cheekbones. If I were to use that foundation brush, it just doesn't blend it as nicely and it leaves some harsh lines there. So that's why I use the Beauty Blender instead of the foundation brush to go ahead and blend. Okay, you guys, so I really try to love this palette. This is the Makeup Revolution Contour Palette. This has a bunch of different shades, the banana shades that you can see here. It has some highlighting shades, the contour shades. You guys will see in a minute why I don't like this palette, but I'm going in with the banana shade as well as the peach-like skin tone shade to go ahead and set my face. I am using the concealer brush again, the pointed one, the 224, to use that banana shade to set my under eyes. And then later on, I'm going to go in with that peach shade with the same brush and set underneath my nose, my chin, and my forehead above my eyebrows just so that the foundation and the contour doesn't move around. And then I'm going to go in a little bit and set with some different powder. The banana shade and the peach shade are really good. I also like the highlighting shades. The mirror is really good in this palette too. So for that reason, I may end up keeping this and just use the brown for some shadows if I can get them to not be as muddy. But you guys will see why I don't like them. Here I am going in with my Kat Von D setting powder in the color Translucent and a setting brush by Real Techniques. This powder, you guys, is phenomenal. I've never found a powder that does such a great job at brightening, at really giving that just really great, pretty, flawless look underneath my eyes. And then I'm also going in with a Sedona Lace 602 brush just to give that powder a little bit of unity with the rest of my face. As you saw before, I went in with the powder puff and I kind of placed all of that powder on my face, and then now I'm taking the Sedona Lace brush and just kind of blending that in to make sure that all of the powder blends into my foundation, blends into my contour, and doesn't really sit on top. So because my face was still a little bit wet and not really set as best as I wanted, I went in with a flat top kabuki from Real Techniques and just kind of laid that powder or pressed that powder into my skin just a little bit more. Here is where we run into trouble with this contour kit, you guys. I'm going in with one of my Sedona Lace contour brushes. This is the number FB5. And I, for the life of me, cannot get this contour to work. I'm going to show you guys, I kept it in this video just so you guys can see how rough this contour palette is to work with. I've heard good things, I've heard bad things. I wanted to try it by myself, but because I like the banana shade, the peach shade, the highlighters, the mirror, I think it's worth keeping to try to use the brown shades as shadows. But I am going to let you guys see for like the next 4 minutes how this was the worst contour palette I've ever tried in my life. I don't show you on camera, but I had to go in, wipe it off on my cheekbones, everything else I could kind of work with. But I go in, I wipe it off, it was a mess. It was a mess, you guys. Just watch and you'll see. Alright, so here I try to salvage this contour with my NYX Matte Bronzer in the color Medium, but even this doesn't work. I lay it right on top and it just makes it even more muddy, and I should have known better. I love this bronzer. I love this bronzer. It's such a good bronzer. This NYX bronzer has been a lifesaver in a lot of my makeup tutorials just because I haven't found a really great bronzer that does what I like. But you can see here, I'm going in with that bronzer, trying to save this, trying to see if this contour can even blend out, if I can take another, you know, brush and add some powder in. I've taken the Kat Von D powder, trying to give it a little less harshness. It doesn't work. See, I go in here, I use my Beauty Blender, I lay down some powder, nothing works. So soon after this, I have to go back in, take the makeup off my cheekbones, and then off camera, I put the NYX bronzer back on. So you guys are gonna see that here in just a little bit. Alright guys, so once I feel like I finally salvaged this contour, I go in with my two favorite blushes at the moment. One is by NARS, this one here, and I believe this is a color like Goulou, I'm not sure, let me know in the comments how to say it. But I love this color and I love mixing it with the Urban Decay one that I just bought. It's the 8-Hour Blush. It's a phenomenal blush. This is in the color Rapture. It's a really pretty mauve-y purple. So I take I believe this brush is by Luxie, and it's just a blush brush. I got it in one of my Ipsy bags, and I take the two, and the combination with them both is beautiful. I love placing them on my cheekbones, kind of mixing them together, not really placing one on top of the other, but taking the brush, swirling it around in both, and then placing it on my cheeks. It's really, really a pretty color. I'm just going in to make sure all of my contour and my blush are blended nicely together with that flat kabuki roll techniques. Now to my favorite part, I got my hands on two of the Jouer highlighters, the two I wanted really. I got Citrine and Rose Quartz. I'm going to show you the colors with a swatch here in just a minute. You can see the more golden shade is going to be your Citrine, that's the Citrine color. And then the more pinkish champagne shade is the Rose Quartz. So here I'm swatching them for you just to kind of show you the pigmentation and the payoff. I'm hoping that the Nicole Guerrero highlighting, the glow kit that I just got, I'm hoping that it's as good as these, but these are phenomenal highlighters, you guys. I've been using these every day. I didn't want to waste any product, so I go into my nose and to my Cupid's bow, and then I blend it out with my Real Techniques brush, just so that I didn't have to waste any product. So I'm going in with the BH Cosmetics highlighting brush. I had to remember if this was like the one I wanted, that's why I looked at it, but this brush is really good for laying out these kinds of highlighters where they're more thicker powders, or where they're more thick powders. It's beautiful, look at that glow. I'm shocked. And then I go back in with the Luxie blush brush and with the Real Techniques brush just to kind of give it a little bit more fluidity and to make sure that it's all really nicely blending together so there's no harsh lines between the contour and the blush and the highlight. Going in, blending out a few times, adding more highlight, blending out, adding highlight. Alright you guys, time for the eyes. So here I'm going to go in and finish up one of the eyes off camera just so that I can quickly get to you guys. So I'm going in with the Pure Cosmetics Get a Grip Primer. This eye primer is phenomenal. It's one of the best primers I have ever found. And then I went in with the Peach Tone Skin Tone shade in that Makeup Revolution palette. Set that with my concealer brush, and then I'm going in with the Too Faced Peanut Butter and the Too Faced Natural Matte palettes in my eyes just because I wanted to do like a really pretty sunset type look. So I'm going to go in first. This is going to be more of my transition shade. I wanted to have kind of a lighter gradient going on the top. So I take my crease brush and I go in with the color Honey Butter and lay that down as my transition color.
So my camera was dying and I wanted to charge it, but I didn't want to go and finish my face without you guys. So I did my eyebrow and then just finished this crease color. So jumping back right in.
Alright guys, now it's time to move on with the eyes. I'm going in with the Too Faced Peanut Butter and Jelly palette, and I'm going to place down my crease shade with one of my BH Cosmetics crease brushes,
with the color peanut butter, and then I'm going to use one of my Morphe blended pointers and go in with the color Nuts About You in the outer V. You should always make sure when you go in with a darker crease color that you, or like in the outer V, that you always blend into your crease color to give it a natural gradient effect, that there's no harsh lines. You want to continue to blend with your fingers more near the end of the brush so that you have more control over it. If you place it all the way in the beginning of the brush where the bristles are, you're not going to have as best control as you would if you place your hands all the way back on the brush or your fingers all the way back on the brush. So here I'm going in with my lid shade. I am taking the color Peanut Brittle in the Peanut Butter and Jelly palette and just placing that all over my lid to give it that really nice sunset look. And then I'm going in with one of my Sedona Lace flat shader brushes. This is the Sedona Lace 954. And I'm just laying down that really pretty, I don't even know how to explain it. It's like a copper orange gold yellow tone color. It is so pretty. I've been really into this palette the last couple days, where I used to have an allergy to it, and knock on wood, it's been going really well. So you're just going to see me continually blending this color on my lid while also blending it into my actual eyelid where my other colors are, the crease color, the outer V color. I'm just taking that color, Nuts About You, and blending it into my crease shade. Here I'm going to take the Magnificent Metal Shadow by Stila. This is in the color Gold Goddess, I believe, or Golden Goddess. I'm Gold Goddess, and I'm taking a NYX flat shader brush. I think this is the number 14, but I'm not positive. I'm going to go in and place this on my eyelid first, but because I don't want it to get everywhere, I'm not going to blend it out with the actual applicator. I feel like that gets so messy. I'm going to blend it out with the NYX shader brush just because it works better that way for me, and I don't get it all over my eye. I don't get it in my contacts, and I'm able to blend it out better. Able to blend it in with the other lid color using, like, kind of dipping back into the Peanut Brittle, as you can see here, with that lid brush or the shader brush from Sedona Lace. Alright guys, you can see it's given a really pretty effect so far, blending in everything together. Here I'm just showing you the brushes I used because I felt like that was important for you to see the tips of the brushes so you know how thin I needed to have them in order to blend out all of the eyeshadow. I'm just showing you the brand and then the tip of the brush. I'm also going to now go off camera and I'm going to put on my eyeliner, and I'm also going to put on one of my favorite pairs of lashes at the moment. I'm going to show you what they are in just a second. I wanted to go ahead and make sure that I got all of that extra shadow, kind of that fallout, off of my eyelid, and or rather my cheek. And then I'm going in now with one of the kind of shimmery champagne colors in the Makeup Revolution palette, and I'm going to lay that down with a really, really teeny, teeny, tiny Beat Cosmetics like definer brush underneath my brow bone. I guess I'm not going off camera yet from my liner, but I will in just a minute. You guys will see. I wanted to make sure everything is blended out really nicely and kind of give it a really pretty, I don't know, just like a really pretty, like, dense or like dimmed highlighted look, and then blending that in with my crease color. Here I'm going to go ahead and go off camera with the All Nighter. This is by Urban Decay. This is one of the best eyeliners I've ever found, and they don't sell it anymore, which stinks. You can get it on eBay though. And then I'm going in with the 113s by Ardell. Look at the difference, you guys. It's amazing how my eyes pop with those lashes. All right, so now going back into the Natural Matte Palette for my under eye, I am going to go in first with a Beat Cosmetics V9 Vegan Pencil Brush in the color Chocolate Cookie. And I'm going to dip into that to go really, really close to my lower lash line just to make sure that it's really touching where my lashes meet my eyeball. And then I'm going to be blending that out with my crease color, or with my transition shade, rather. I think that was the color Honey Butter. So my transition shade was Honey Butter, and then also the color that I'm blending out, that Chocolate Cookie, underneath my lower lash line, is also the color Honey Butter. And I'm just taking the same transition shade brush that I used in my transition, obviously, for that, like kind of like blending that out, diffusing that underneath my eyelid, or my eyeball, yeah, my lower lash line. Alright guys, so I decided to do my inner corner a little bit differently. Rather than put kind of an icy white shade in my inner corner, I went with the color Senegal from the Juvia's Place palette and one of my Makeup Forever pencil brushes. I just wanted to give this some life, and I felt like putting a gold shade in my inner corner would make it so pretty, and it really did give it a nice effect. The pencil brush I'm going in with, I don't think it has a number. It's just marked pencil brush under Makeup Forever. So you can kind of see how I'm blending everything in though. Blending in that inner corner shade, that Senegal shade from the Juvia's Place palette, into my lower lash line with the other color, the Chocolate Chip Cookie, or the Chocolate Cookie. And then I'm going back in with that color Honey Butter, making sure everything is nice and blended and that it doesn't have any harsh lines. Sometimes when you put an inner corner color, especially one that's more gold rather than a white base, it can get really messy and just look kind of everywhere. So you want to make sure you go in and you clean it up with all of your transition colors and a powder brush kind of underneath that lower lash line, just to make sure that you have everything blended out nicely and there's not a lot of fallout. Alrighty guys, so now I'm going in with my favorite mascara at the moment. This is by Maybelline. This is the Big Eyes Falsies Mascara in Waterproof. And I'm just going to place some mascara on my inner corner, on my lower lashes, so that everything kind of looks cohesive, blends nicely together. I feel like when you put mascara on your lower lash line, the look just kind of comes together and fits really nicely. So I'm just going to do that. You're going to see the mirror in front of me for a while. I'm sorry about that. I tried to make sure that most of my eye you were able to see. And then I'm just going in a little tiny bit. I don't normally put mascara on my lashes, but I felt like I needed to blend my lashes a little bit better. So I went in with that mascara and I just placed it a little bit at the tips, or like at the bottom of my lashes, where I glued them to my regular lashes. I just wanted to make sure that they blended in as nice as possible. Alright guys, so another one of my favorite makeup applications has to be the lipstick. Right now I'm loving the liquid lipsticks by Smashbox. These are the Always On liquid lipsticks. I'm trying to decide between the color In Demand and Out Loud. I went with the color Out Loud just because I wanted this to look like more of a sunset, bronze, summery, spring look. And I felt like the In Demand was a little bit too pink for it. If I had more of a nude eye, I probably would have done the In Demand. But this look I'm going with the Out Loud just because it really gives it off, it really gives it a nice, like sunset bronzy summery look. It takes me forever to apply this, but I wanted to include it in the video so you guys can see how long it takes me to put lipstick on. Alright, so now that I finally have my lipstick applied, I'm going in with some of my favorite setting sprays at the moment. I love the MAC Fix Plus just because of the smell. It does set the makeup okay. And then after that, I go in with my Urban Decay All Nighter Setting Spray. This one does a really good job at setting the makeup, but I felt like I needed a third. Love this third setting spray. This is the Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. One of my favorites. It's a godsend, you guys. It's so good. That's it. Here are just some pictures of the final look. I really like how it came out. I hope you guys do too. I include these just so you guys can kind of see. I really have fun, you guys. I love it. I have fun. It turned out well. I liked this look, so I did want to go ahead and include it just because I was proud of it. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Have a great night. Stay tuned for my outro. Have some news for you. Bye-bye.
I did just want to thank you guys so much for spending this time with me. I know sometimes my Get Ready With Me videos are a bit long, but that's only because I like to involve you in the entire process. I like to show you my techniques, and I just kind of like to chat with you. I did decide to do this one as a voiceover just because I haven't done one in a while and I really wanted to kind of explain some products and things like that, so I thought it would be better to do a voiceover. And since I am feeling better, why not just jump back in full throttle? Anyway, I really do hope that you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much again for watching and supporting me. If you are not subscribed yet, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up or a like if you are into my Get Ready With Me videos. If you think that there's something else you want me to do or something else you want me to change, add, or try out, then go ahead and also leave a comment down below. Please remember to hit that notification bell so that you know when I do upload videos, which is at least 2 to 3 times a week when I'm not sick. I'm hoping to go ahead and upload a haul video here pretty quick, and then hopefully another tutorial for another spring and summer look. I am so ready for spring and summer to start. Oh, I can't wait for it to come. So anyway, I hope that you really enjoyed this orange bronze type peanut butter and jelly-ish two-faced smashbox based tutorial Get Ready With Me. And remember guys, don't ever let anybody tell you that you have to be something that you don't want to be. Mwah. I'll see you guys soon. Bye.